Today you're going to see how to control your MP3 player music volume using hand gestures, Arduino, and the Sparkfun MP3 Player Shield. We're going to use the ultrasonic sensor to detect our hand gestures, and those gestures are going to be basically, if you want to increase the volume of your music, you move your hand closer to the sensor. If you want to decrease the volume, you move your hand away, and you'll see how it works. It's pretty neat.
I'll post the code to the Facebook page,
so be sure to check that out. In the meantime, let's take a look at it.
We'll be using the HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor. We'll be using some breadboard jumper wires. We'll be using a breadboard. I'm using the breadboard, the Sparkfun breadboard, but you can use any Arduino Uno or Mega for that matter. You just have to rewire the shield. And on top, I have the Sparkfun MP3 player shield. It's connected here to a USB to the computer, and it's connected to an audio cable. And for my active speaker, I'm using the Ounce Angle 3 Pro. You can use any active speaker, but it does need to be active to get the sound to come out. And then toward the end of the video, I'll show you how to make it totally wireless using battery power and an SPST on-off toggle switch. We just toggle the whole thing on and off. And then here we got the connectors, so we'll do that at the end. That's what I'm using today.
The HCSR04 is a popular and cheap ultrasonic distance sensor that's commonly used with robotics, automation, and various other DIY projects. This sensor uses ultrasonic waves to measure the distance between a sensor and an object, and it works by sending out ultrasonic pulses that we cannot hear, and it listens for the echo. And the time it takes for the pulse to bounce back allows the sensor to calculate the distance to the object. This is a 4-pin module that operates on 5 volts, operating current of 15 milliamp, operating frequency of 40 kilohertz. The maximum range is 4 meters, and the minimum range is 2 centimeters.
I'll also be using the Sparkfun MP3 Player Shield. It is a really nice MP3 decoder. If MP3s aren't your thing, they also support other audio files, including WMA and MIDI files. I have several videos, including this MP3 Player Shield, and it's been a really great shield, easy to use. And you do have to solder in your own headers. I use the stacking headers, and that's been super easy as well. What I do like about this is that once you buy it, you can come right over here to Documents, and the hookup guide is probably my favorite part of the whole website on Sparkfun. So you go to the hookup guide, it tells you everything you ever wanted or need to know about this MP3 player shield, including old versions and new versions. And if you come down here, it'll tell you every pin that you can and cannot use and what each pin does. You can use serial pins, RX and TX. You can use a SPI interface here at 11, 12, and 13. I often use the digital PWM pins at 5 and 10. You can also use all of these analog pins, the ground pins, the 5-volt, 3-volt, and any others that I have forgotten. It's all right here. And if you come down here, it also tells you how to format your SD card. You got to format it in FAT32. It also supports FAT16. So very helpful. They also give you some code to get off the ground. So you can come down here, copy this code, copy it right into your Arduino IDE, and you're good to go. You will, however, have to download the library before you get this up and going. The easier way to do it is to come right down here and click on the GitHub repository, and it takes you to the Sparkfun GitHub. And from the Sparkfun GitHub page here, you could just go to code, download your zip file, and then unzip that and put those files directly into your Arduino directory, your Arduino IDE directory, and you can access those from there. You would open up your Arduino IDE, go to File, go to Examples, and then find the library that you just installed. And here it is right here. They've got some, they've got 4 different examples for you here, and you can just pick one and try it out. That's the easiest way to get started. But let's get on with our project here and take a look at the code we'll be using today. Here's a quick look at the code we're using. It's fairly short, so this shouldn't take very long. We're using the three libraries here, the SPI library, the SDFAT library, and the SFMP3 shield library. Down here we define the trigger pin on pin 10 and the echo pin on pin 5. Here on line 10 we create an SD instance of the class SDFAT. Remember, SDFAT allows us to interface the SD card on our Arduino. And then below that we create an MP3 player instance of the SFMP3 shield class, and that allows us to access our MP3 player shield. And down here we store a random number in our code as we select a random song in the list of songs. We only have 10, but it's randomized. And below that we have the time of the last track played, which is 0, and then the track played delay is 8. That allows us to do an 8-second delay between songs. In the setup, we set serial communication at a baud speed of 11,5200. We also set the trigger pin as an output and the echo pin as an input in pin mode. This portion right here initializes the SD card in the MP3 player shield. On line 25, it tries to initialize the SD card on pin 9 with a data transfer speed of half of the spy bus speed. And if that fails to initialize, we carry out this little if block right here. And this first line here, this checks if the program can change the directory to the root directory of the SD card. And if you can't, you get this nice little message right here on your serial monitor. But assuming that it does initialize, we come down here, it'll initialize the MP3 player, and it will set the volume for the left and the right channel to 10. And we also set up this nice message right here for our serial monitor, the ultrasonic mode activated message. And then down here we set up the random seed on analog pin 0 to ensure that our songs are randomized when they're selected. And then we move down here to the loop. And in this portion, the loop repeats over and over again. The trigger pin starts out low for 2 milliseconds, then the trigger pin goes high for 10 milliseconds, and then the trigger pin goes back low again. Once the echo pin goes high, we know that the pulse has been received, comes back to the sensor, and then duration can be converted to distance in centimeters. This part maps distance to volume range. Here at line 53, this maps the distance value ranging from 0 to 200 centimeters to a volume range of 0 to 254. And the line below that checks to see if the distance is out of range, a range greater than 200 centimeters. If so, the volume goes to 0, but I can tell you that doesn't always happen. It goes soft, but not always to 0, so maybe it's just my sensor. I'm not sure. In the next part here, we set the volume of the MP3 player. We'll come down here to the last portion of our code. This if condition checks if the time elapsed since the last track was played is greater than or equal to the track play delay. It also checks to see if the distance measured is less than or equal to 200 centimeters. If both of these conditions are met, we generate a random track number, and this is between files 1 and 10, assuming you have 10 MP3 tracks on your SD card. And then down here we play the file associated with the random number that was chosen. And then the last one right here, we update the time the last track was played, and then this loop starts over and over again. So I altered the code just a little bit so that there's a gradual change in volume instead of an abrupt change. And this modified code is the one that I will post on the Facebook page. So before I altered the code, there was a real spike in the volume when I put my hand right in front like this, but you can tell there's a gradual increase, which I really like. This is a 12-volt battery I recently purchased. It works great with Arduino, and it's got the male and female connectors on it, which I really like. So we're going to go ahead and connect my switch here to the battery. Plug everything in and then just flip the whole thing on. That way we can make it wireless. Thank you all very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If this was helpful to you, be sure to like the video, leave a comment, ask a question, whatever you want to do, and make sure you check out the Facebook page. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you again very soon.